Not only Tekken Tag Tournament 2 can be played on PC with RPCS3, but we can also play it online. The RPCN network is used for that, and in this step-by-step video, I'll show you how to play the game on PC with the best settings and how to play online as well. We'll begin by downloading RPCS3, the PS3 emulator. I'll put the link down below, and here on the main page, you just have to click here on the download button, and then you download the emulator for the operational system you're using. In my case, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna click on this one and then place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zipped file, so you have to extract it with either WinRAR or 7-zip. In my case, I'm using 7-zip, so I'm just gonna extract the file here. And you can go ahead and delete the original one. We're not gonna need that anymore. And to begin, you just have to double click here on rpcs3.exe to start the installation. And here there's a few options if you want to create a desktop shortcut and stuff. I would not recommend using the dark theme yet, so I'm gonna turn this off. And then just click here on do not show again, and I have read the quick start guide. And then just select here on continue. And there you go, we have RPCS3 on our computer. First, we have to install the PS3 firmware on the emulator, and we can get that on the official Sony website. This is the place right here, the link will be down below, and on this page, you want to scroll down here to the bottom a little bit, and where it says how to update PS3 system software, you want to click here on update using a computer, and then you just click on download PS3 update, and place the file on the same emulator folder. If for some reason the download doesn't start when you click on it, then you have to click on it with the right button on your mouse, and then select copy link address, and then paste the link on your browser and press enter. Then the download will start. Now back on the emulator folder, I already downloaded my firmware here. It is this file, the PS3 update. Now you wanna go to the emulator and right here, click on file and click on install firmware. It should open the emulator folder by default. So now you just have to double click here on the PS3 update and it will install the firmware on RPCS3. Click here and do not show again, and then click OK. And now it will install these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. And while you wait for it to finish, this will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. Now it is the time to install Tekken on RPCS3. And of course, I can't show you here on the video where to go to get the game. So you're gonna have to either dump your copy of the game into your PC or find it online. But this is something that I can't do because it's against YouTube's policy. When you install the emulator, it already created a games folder for you. So this is where we're gonna be placing the game. You can go ahead and delete these two folders right here. We're not gonna need that anymore. And I'm gonna go ahead and create a new folder here called Tekken Tag 2, just so that I know that this is the folder for this game. And inside this folder, this is where I'm gonna be placing the game files. Click here on File again, and then click on Install Packages. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you wanna browse through the games folder, and then double click on the Tekken folder. And then you can highlight everything like this with your mouse so we can install it in one go. Now just click here on open, and then on the emulator it's gonna ask if you want to install these files, the game itself and the DLC. So then just click on install and wait until it finishes. Installation is done, so click here on okay. And even though we have the game, it's not updated to version 1.01 yet, which is required to play this game online. And luckily there is an easy way to update your games on RPCS3. Using this tool right here, Rusty PSN, the link will be down below as well. So here on this page, you just want to click here on the latest release available. It is version 3.7, and then just scroll down here to the bottom, and you have to download this file right here, the Rusty PSN EGI Windows.zip. Download this file if you are using Windows like I am. You can place it on the same emulator folder. Now back on the RPCS3 folder, the file is right here, the Rusty PSN that is, so you just have to extract the single .exe file that is inside of it with either WinRAR or 7-zip here. And then now you just have to double click here on the Rusty PSN.exe and the tool will open. Before you start downloading the patches, I want you to click here on this little gear so you can change the download location for the patches. In my case, I like to create a new folder on the emulator folder here called updates, just so that I can keep things organized, you know? And now go back to Rusty PSN and then select pick folder and then select that one updates folder that we just created. Remember, this is optional. This is up to you how you want to download this, but I like doing it like this. So now click here on save settings, and to download the patches for any game, we're gonna need its serial code, and we can get that on the emulator here. On the game you just got, right click on it, in this case Tekken 2, and then go to copy info on the bottom and then click on copy serial here. Now go back to Rusty PSN and then you're gonna paste that serial code here like this. Now click on search for updates, and just like that, Rusty PSN will list the updates available for the game. In this case, there's only one update for Tekken Tag Tournament 2, so now you just want to click here on download file, wait for it to finish, and there you go. Now you can close Rusty PSN, and back on the emulator, click here on file, and then install packages again, and select that updates folder that we just created. There will be another folder inside with the serial code of the game and inside the actual update itself. So now I just gotta double click on it. Gonna ask if you want to install this, of course. Click on yes, and there you go. Now the game is updated. Now we're going to create an account on the RPCN network, which is required to play these games online here. So here in the emulator, on configuration, click on it, and then select the RPCN option right here. This window will show up and you're gonna start by clicking here on account, and then here you're gonna click on create account, and first you're going to create your username account right here. So select the name that you want to use and then click on OK, and here you're gonna type the password that you want to use, of course, then click on OK, and lastly you're gonna type the email that you have so you can receive the token code, so you can access the online functionalities of RPCN and play the game online. Click on OK, and this window will show up saying that you have created your account, but you need the token code on your email to activate your account. So head over to your email inbox and you're gonna receive a message exactly like this one that says your token for RPCN and then the code right here. So obviously you're gonna copy your code as such and paste your token right here and then select OK. Now the username that you have created is going to show up right here. So lastly, just click here on test account to make sure that everything worked fine. And there you go. You're gonna see this message here saying your account is valid. You're good to go now. So click on OK. And you can close this down too. You notice that there is a friends option here available, and you can actually add other people that also have a RPCN account to play with them online. So if you know someone that wants to play online as well, you just have to click here on friends and then click on add friend and then type his ID right here and then add him and then add that person as a friend. With your account created, we are now going to click on the game with the right button and then click here on create custom configuration. And here on the network tab, by default, it's going to look like this, and you're going to change this starting with the network status from disconnected to connected. Leave the DNS server like this one. This game does not require any custom server for online play, and here on PSN status, change from disconnected to RPCN. And since we are here, we can configure the RPCS3 settings to give us the best performance and graphics in-game. And for this game, you want to click here on GPU. Make sure that the render is set to Vulkan, but if your GPU is a little outdated, you're only gonna have the OpenGL option, but if not, preferably set this one to Vulkan. On an isotropic filter, you can change this one to 16x. This will make the game look much better and has minimal impact on performance. And if you want to increase the game resolution here, keep the default at 720p and increase the resolution scale right here. This game is well optimized already on RPCS3, and in my case, I could even play this at 4K resolution at 60 FPS. But of course, this is gonna depend on how strong your CPU is. In my case, my CPU is considered A tier on the CPU ranking table. So you wanna check that information yourself, but keep testing this until you get the quality that you want. And on additional settings, enable write color buffers here. And also, this part is optional, but I like going here to the emulator and disabling the show trophy pop-ups, the PPU compilation hint, and the shader compilation as well. They can be annoying because every time the game is building the shaders and the PPU, it's going to show as a notification while in-game. So I like turning these off. And we're done here, so now click on apply and then save configuration. And lastly, we have to configure the controller. So click here on pads. And if you already have your controller plugged in, you're gonna click here on handlers and select the device you're using. In my case, I'm using a Xbox controller, so I'm gonna use X input, and the RPCS3 will do the automatic mapping for you. You can use keyboards as well, if that's what you want to play here too. It works just as fine. Now click on save and we're good to go. So now I just have to double click here on the game. And when you start this for the first time, this message will show up from your firewall, and you definitely want to click here on allow access. Otherwise, you're going to have problems connecting with other players. Now I just have to wait until it finishes compile these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long depending on how powerful your PC is. If everything worked out, you're going to see your RPCN ID right here. You can just go here to online mode. Gonna display this error message, but don't worry, that's normal here. Just click on OK and keep going. And the online functions for this game are all working. You can even check the leaderboard as well here. These are all players who played on the emulator. You can play ranked if you feel like it, and you can also create a lobby as well. And like I showed you, the RPCN has a friends list feature here. So if you create a lobby and then go to menu display, then click on friend invite, you can invite your RPCN friends to play with you online here. I have many videos like this on the channel covering how to install and play games on PC, focusing on the best graphics and performance, and I always teach in the easiest way to understand. So if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and check out my other stuff. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.